Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're out at the range with a brand new product from Manticore Arms, and it's a magazine for the Scorpion EVO, 9mm EVO. Over the last year or so, I've been seeing reports that the factory EVO magazines have been suffering from feed lip failures. These polymer magazines are not reinforced. The feed lips are plastic, much like, say, a P-Mag. And folks are reporting cracked feed lips and sending them back to CZ for warranty work. Well, Manticore Arms, not to sit too long on their laurels, decided they might have a possible solution to that problem, and they've brought a new product to market, which I'll show you guys here in a second. But first, let me dump my 20 rounds of ammunition out of my EVO into my rubber dummy target downrange. Then we'll grab those new magazines and give you guys a peek. Man, I love this gun. Let's check these new magazines out. Let's go ahead and get this factory 20 round magazine out of the gun and take a look at the two new magazines by Manticore Arms. They're offering two different versions of the magazine. One is a smoke colored magazine, kind of similar in appearance to the factory magazine, and the other one is just straight up transparent. The magazines are marked on one side, designed by Manticore Arms, and then Prepper Gun Shop on the other side and made in the USA. So these are USA made magazines, which count as a compliance part if you're counting parts. The magazines have the same profile as a factory magazine. I have a factory 30 rounder here, and you can see that the factory 30 rounder and the Manticore are pretty much the same profile. Of course, they would have to be, given that they would have to fit the same gun, obviously. But there are a couple of key differences, and maybe you've picked that up already. Whereas the factory magazine has polymer feed lips, the Manticore Arms magazine has steel feed lips and a polymer body. Another key difference is the fact that the Manticore will accept 32 rounds, whereas the factory magazine only accepts 30. So you get two extra rounds. You get, obviously, magazine compatibility. Any pouches you may have, they're going to work in still, although the magazine will be a little bit longer if you have a flap-type pouch. But if you have a bungee-type retention system or just a friction-type retention system, it's not going to change because the profiles are pretty much identical, just a slightly longer magazine. Disassembly is the same. You can see the floor plates are very similar. And they're both made of modern polymers. What the exact makeup of the polymer is, I don't know, but I'm going to go ahead and guess. Given the feeling of it, it's very, very similar to what CZ is using. So if we take a close-up look at the magazine, we can see how the feed lips wrap around the magazine, curl over here, and engage the polymer. And if you've seen this type of design before, it's probably because you've seen Lancer magazines. The SIG MPX, for example, has these steel feed lips, and those magazines are manufactured by Lancer. Of course, you can find steel reinforced feed lips on the Lancer 5 magazines and their 308 magazines and stuff like that. So we've seen that done before. But how does that relate to durability? Only time will tell, but we do know that quite a few folks have been, again, having problems with their factory magazines and these feed lips, which are polymer, breaking off after they leave them loaded for a while, especially if they drop them nose down. So we're going to do a little bit of shooting with these new magazines to see how reliable they are, and then give you guys some feedback on them. Now, the price on these guys is going to be right around $29 MSRP. The factory magazines you can find all day long online. They're commonly available for around $19.99, $19.95. So let's just say $20. And these are going to be $29.95, I think, MSRP. But we can expect to see these sell for something less than that. These will probably wind up being around $25 a magazine. So you're going to pay $5 more for a magazine that has steel feed lips. Is it worth it or not? That's yet to be, you know, seen. I don't know. I want to shoot them quite a bit before I pass judgment on them. Today's just kind of a Hello Magazine video. You can tell these things are brand spanking new. I just took them out of the box. So I'm going to shoot them a lot more before I give a final verdict. That'll come in another video. But today, we're just going to start putting them through their paces and see how they hold up. This is the first 32 rounds I fired out of one of the new Manticore magazines. So let's see how it goes. Hopefully it works fine. Well, there was flawless function from the first 32 rounds. Now I've only loaded 30 rounds into the second magazine. Even though they have 32 round capability, I'll probably only load 30 rounds because I'm one of those weirdos that always loads my magazines a certain way. I, you know, load from a row, from row, from row in the box, and I only load in variables of 5. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and 30. So I probably will never use the 32 round feature unless I leave the magazine in the gun for self-defense or something like that. And flawless function from the smoke magazine. I only have 2 of them. These things are still in production. They're kind enough to send me a couple of test samples. So we're gonna load these guys up, do some more shooting, and see how they hold up. Before we load up some new magazines, you guys probably have some questions about how my EVO is configured. I've done a video on it, but in case you haven't seen those other videos, just quickly give you a rundown because this doesn't look like your average EVO. So first of all, I have a Magpul stock on it. This is a Zhukov stock. It's mounted via a Side Project LLC mount. It gives you the same functionality as you would normally expect from a Zhukov stock. It folds to the side, it's more in line, and it's a little bit lighter weight, the Zhukov is, than the standard factory Scorpion EVO stock. I really like the Side Project mount. Pistol grip is Yeti Works, and this is one of their new molded ones. They're no longer 3D printed, now they're molded. I have an Aimpoint T1 Micro on top, and it's mounted via Midwest Industries Quick Detach mount. The handguard is a CZ factory carbine handguard. They started producing these just at the end of last year for the 16-inch barreled rifles to also fit your pistol, which this was before I SBR'd it. And it just so happens that a Silencer Co. Omega 9K will fit perfectly inside there. And it's almost like the two were made for each other. So this gun's pretty much permanently suppressed. It's a really neat little setup. That can is hot already. I can feel the heat at the tip of my thumb, but my hand is completely shielded from the heat of the suppressor right here when I'm grabbing it. So I'm able to actually grab a little bit further forward, which is really nice when you have Yeti length arms. The one other thing I didn't point out was the gear head works selector lever. So I can quickly go from fire to safe. It's on safe right now. If I want to go to fire, I just push up with my finger and go down to the trigger. And when I want to make it safe, I just pull down the lever and I can just index and feel whether or not the gun's on safe. It's a nice addition also to the gun. All right, so we have a couple of different types of ammo out here. We have some 124 grain Fiocchi, which is what we opened the video with. And we also have some 124 grain Freedom munitions, which we're going to load up next. And this is the factory magazine and these are the two new ones. So you can see from just having one magazine shot through the gun, we've already got it all crudded up. So this clear one's gonna get dirty pretty quickly, especially if you're running the gun with a suppressor. You're gonna see that carbon work its way down. You can field strip the magazines very easily. Just take the tip of a bullet, push that in, floor plate comes off. It's just like any other magazine. So just a personal preference there. I would probably go with the smoke magazine because it handles the carbon a little bit better. These things are gonna get pretty nasty looking pretty quickly, I would imagine. But some folks, if you want to keep cleaning them, probably like the look of the fully transparent magazine. Factory magazine, hit the release. I can shake it out. The Manticore Arms. Can't shake it out, but it slides right out. So perhaps just a little bit more friction, but not a whole lot. Because the gun is designed the way that it is, I don't know that I would rely on gravity to do my work for me. Go ahead and just pull the magazine out and grab another one and stick it in. The magazine well on this bad boy is beveled nicely. I really just think the controls on the Scorpion are just amazing. Magazines are really easy to insert. It's just intuitive to grab them out because you can either use your thumb here to release the magazine as you're pulling it out, or you can use your index finger to release the magazine and again, pull it out. Really well thought out gun. Let's let Jason shoot it and see what he thinks.
do have to say, firing this thing as many times as we have, I'm feeling absolutely nothing coming through this handguard. It's really nice. No malfunctions at all.
So I'm curious, which probably means you're curious, how well do the Manticore Arms magazines handle being dropped from shoulder height onto gravel as compared to the factory polymer magazines that do not have the steel reinforced feed lips? Well, that's what we're going to find out right now. At my feet, I have gravel. And I'm going to drop the magazines from shoulder height because realistically, we'll probably never find the magazines being dropped from a building. I guess it could happen, but you're probably not going to retrieve it and use it in a fight anyway. You're probably going to wind up dropping it out of the gun or dropping it while you're doing a reload or something like that. So we're going to drop it from shoulder height, which is maybe a little bit higher than it would normally fall. And I'm 6'4", straight into gravel. We'll try to line it up so the feed lips hit the gravel first. And here we go with the factory magazine. Three drops. One. I don't see any cracks or any failures. Two. I hit on one feed lip more than the other. Put a nice boogie mark in it. But I don't see any cracks. And then three. Did the bullet go fine? Yep. Shot a bullet out. Which is expected. When they bounce, it releases the spring tension momentarily and rounds can fly out. But I do not see any types of failures on either of the feed lips. Let's go ahead and put this round that popped out back in, which can be a little bit challenging when it's this cold outside and my fingers are numb. All right. Everything seems to be looking pretty darn good. All right, let's try the Manticore magazine. Same little heap of gravel there, shoulder height. Drop it straight on the feed lips as best I can. One. Definitely some boogie marks in the metal. Does not look as though the lips are deformed from being dropped. Do not believe. Let's see, drop it again. Two. Looks about the same. And three. And a little bit chewed up. The ultimate test will be if they work in the gun. We'll do the Manticore magazine first. Locks open just fine. Now we'll grab the factory magazine. See how it works. And it works just fine. So it would seem that both of the magazines handle being dropped really well. I don't see any failures at all. So that's good news for both of them. We have some bowling pins set up about 50 yards down range. Now I don't recommend shooting at bowling pins, guys. These are just left out here. I'm gonna shoot at them, but they can be pretty dangerous. I've seen bullets come back off of them. But right after I say that, here I go, shooting at them with my Scorpion 9mm. 124 grain ball for the munitions. And the Manticore magazine, even though it kind of looks like a factory magazine. Let's see how she does. Is it soaking up those 9mm? No way. silencer rubber dummy in the abdomen here. So this is interesting, guys. So I was sitting there shooting at the pins. I know this gun is zeroed, and it wasn't hitting the pins. And then I looked at the rubber dummy. I tried to shoot at the abdomen, at the belly button of the rubber dummy, and it wasn't even hitting the rubber dummy. I thought, what in the world? So quickly checked the red dot sight. One of the things I advocate for is setting your red dot sight to your iron sights so you can do a quick reality check. I looked at the sights, and the red dot's sitting right on top of the post. They're zeroed together. So I looked at the can, and I can see the can through this little M-lock rail. It didn't look loose. It was a quarter turn loose. It's a direct thread can, which may change. I may have to go to a QD mount, which will make this stick out a little bit further. A quarter of a turn on the suppressor because it was just starting to get loose, and it was causing those rounds to go wildly off target to the point that it missed a man-sized target at about 30 yards. Now that we have the can tightened back down, which I strap wrench it on typically, I can actually hit the bowling pins. Check this out. That can, just a quarter turn loose, it wasn't hitting anything, wasn't coming anywhere near those targets. Keep that in mind. It's also a good way to get a baffle strike. So I should have checked it. I thought it had it set on there pretty good. All right, guys, it's time to wind things up. I hope you enjoyed coming out to the range with us this afternoon and shooting the new Manticore Arms 32 round Scorpion EVO magazines for 9mm. They're going to come to market again at $29.95, I believe, is full MSRP. Again, we should see them sell for around $25 or $26 a piece. So you're going to have about $5 or $6 more into the magazines over the factory originals. Now, if you're one of those guys or girls out there that's been having problems with your factory polymer magazines and you've been having feed lip failures, you'll probably want to check these out. They should be announced at SHOT Show, which is coming up here next week. And again, they should be available hopefully here very soon. We'll probably wind up carrying them at Copper Custom. If you guys have any questions about anything that you've seen in this video, you can ask those questions down below. I do try to stick around for the first couple of days after a video goes live to answer the questions you guys may have. Also, if you would like to support the Military Arms channel, please swing by and check out Copper Custom. It's the best possible way to support us here at the channel. And if you haven't already, please check out full30.com. That's full30.com. We've taken all the web's best firearms content creators, brought them under one roof, and that is full30.com. Thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks for all those years of support, and we'll see you guys soon. And that's with the factory trigger. Not that it's super fast, but it's heavy, but it works.